Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, we're going to be answering a question that was asked on Reddit, where someone asked how to make a curved rectangle that covers this curved wall. Basically, they have four arcs here, and they want to make a shape that essentially connects all those four arcs. We're going to be jumping into that after the intro. All right, so a lot of people in the answer to this question on Reddit were saying essentially that you could do this with different plugins, and that's certainly true, but no one was talking about how you could do this in SketchUp without using a plugin, and it's actually pretty simple. So I figured I'd chime in and make this video showing how you can make these four arcs in the vanilla version of SketchUp. So I've opened SketchUp here, and what I'm going to do is start by making the four arcs. Now, the way that I'm going to do this is very specific. I was having issues with this earlier, and basically what I think was happening is that the arcs weren't completely parallel. So what I'm going to do, just to make sure, is I'm going to draw a rectangle, and I'm just going to make sure that it's fairly large because SketchUp doesn't like small increments. So you just want to make sure that when you're drawing something, that it's if it's not working or it's not working how you think, you may want to try scaling it up. So we're just going to use the arc tool, draw that. So let's smush this a little. Okay, so we have that. And then I'm just going to click into this and make it a group. And then I'm going to do the rectangle tool again. I'm going to hit the left arrow key. That's going to allow me to draw on this green axis. A for the arc tool, select my endpoint, and then I'm going to select, hold shift here to lock to that plane, and then select my center point. E for the eraser tool and delete the rest of this stuff. Double click into this, right click, make group. Okay, so now we have these two guys, and essentially if you need it, if I just copy these, I hit M to move, and then as I start to move, I hit Control to make a copy. That's basically what we had. There was a box behind it, but basically this is the shape that they're trying to connect the arcs. So what I'm going to do here is select. I'm going to hit Control here to select this guy in addition to the other one. Hit M to move. As I start to move, hit Control, and it'll make a copy. Now I'm going to double click into this. Now that's a group and it gives me this editing option. Hit P to push pull. Go all the way across. Go out of that group by hitting escape. And go into this other group by double clicking P. Okay, so now we have these two intersecting shapes. Now I'm going to be using the solid tools here. If you don't see this, this is in the vanilla version of SketchUp. So what you need to do is right click in an open space in your toolbar. Go down to where it says solid tools and make sure that this is checked. If this is missing or you can't find it, you can always uncheck and then check it again and it'll pop up. And then you can dock it where you want or leave it outside. What we're going to be using today is called intersect. As I mouse over this, you can see it says intersect all the solids but keep only their intersection something in the model. So basically what that means is that it's going to get rid of these extra like pieces and it's just going to keep what is resultant. One thing that I didn't point out earlier, and I'll just show you really quick, is that as I hit A, you can see in the bottom right it says sides. Everything in SketchUp is made of sides. So an arc is a curved shape, but actually in SketchUp it's a bunch of line segments. So if you want a smoother looking line, and in this case it's going to affect the final look, you want to just make this number higher as you go through and make your arcs. So just something to be aware of before we get into this. Now I'm going to hit intersect, and then it's going to, as I mouse over these groups, because they're solid, that means they're completely filled in. Sometimes you may need to check like the back shape, or you may have a line inside or an extra face inside. So you just need to make sure that they're completely solid groups without any extra things. This is pretty simple, so you can see that it's pretty easy. So I had a little one when I clicked the first one, and then the second one, it kind of looks like they're the same because they're in the same, occupying the same space. And then it gives me a little two for the second step. Now you can see that we get this guy. I think probably the arcs weren't 100% connected, which is why we have this little, or they weren't exactly the same. They weren't meeting at the same point, which is why we get this. But if you want to get rid of these other lines to sort of smooth it out, you can come in, hit E, and then hit Control. This is one way to do it. You just hide these lines. Or you can just double click onto this and then in your default tray, go to soften edges and you can just increase this. So you can see we have some pretty soft edges right there. Now you can see that there's like some lines going across here, and that is from the arc side. So basically what it's doing is it's connecting these shapes together from those arcs. So if you want to make these less frequent, or I guess they would be more frequent, but hopefully less noticeable because of the change of lighting, would be more subtle, would be more of a gradient if they're smaller. Yeah, hopefully this helped. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.